Welcome to the online classes, guys. Thank you very much for joining in the online class of Human Computer Interaction at Department of Computers and Binary Production University, Lahore, Karachi. Today, we have some introductory about the information of human computer interaction. After that, we go to the topics we left here. Previously, we have covered a lot of topics in the previous classes before the commence of the midterm examination due to the COVID-19 disaster. Thank you very much for joining and listening. Guys, I have to give you some brief of the HCI, and also I have made a video over the book referred by reference book about the HCI of Dr. Professor Keith Andrews. So it will be uploaded at the YouTube channel and shared with you on the WhatsApp group so that you can easily understand that the topics and discussions whatever we have. And also I will record this meeting so that some other kind of information will also be shared with you on the YouTube channel. Okay, see you all, guys. Here, and this is the what we have. Okay. Human computer interaction and overview. It is already discussed in our class. Today we go to the review these topics and come to the our remaining topics to inshallah if we can. And so human computer interaction covered in this lecture: what is human computer interaction, importance of HCI, good and poor design examples we have discussed in the previous classes, general principles of HCI design, what is the design, types of design, what is good or bad, normal principles of usability, conceptual modeling, how conceptual modeling helps us to design of how human, what is HCI. Guys, we know that HCI is the three components combined this field of study in the computing science, which helps the technology to improve the design and satisfy the users. The goal of the HCI is to satisfy the user about the design, about the product. How human interacts with the computer? Computer are machines, are automated things. Not primarily the study of human. We are not focusing primarily, basically, on the human study, but just the cognition, the behavior of the humans, and the attitude of the humans about the computing machines. Not primarily the study of computer. We are not talking about the applications, their usage. We are just talking or studying about the things interfaces with users when they use in daily life. The study of bridge between them, which includes observations of interactions between people and computers. So this is the HCI. The term SCI was adopted in 1980. The Association for Computing Machine, ACM, first introduced the definition of this field. Discipline concerned with the design, evolution, and implementation of interactive computer systems for human use and with the study of major phenomena surrounding them. So still, this is the popular definition. And so many definitions are available regarding the HCI, but this is the standard definition internationally accepted by the all corners of the technology. Okay, what is HCI? Human individual user, a group of users working together, a sequence of users in an organization. Means we are humans, means we're talking about the users of our, who use the computing things. And computer, in computer sense, desktop computer, large scale computer systems, smartphones, embedded systems, photocopier, microwave, softwares, where we have some kind of automation, etc. A user interface is such like a part of the computer that user contacts with the screen, mouse, keyboard, switch, button, etc. Through which we interact with the machine. Interaction usually involve a dialogue with feedback and control throughout performing a task. So this is all what we have HCI. So we are lifting, forwarding this. These are the already discussed in the previous classes, the goal. The important thing is what goals HCI has. Understand the factors that determine how people use technology. So at physical level, HCI concerns selecting the most appropriate input devices. Okay guys, welcome to all you who are late joining. We have already started. At physical level, HCI concerns selecting the most appropriate input devices and output devices for a particular interface. Here we have a system that includes computer develop or improve. So what parameters have been considered for the designing of the any product? One is safety of the user of the products, utility, effectiveness, efficiency, usability, and appeal. These are the important factors considered in the HCI when we are designing our conceptual modeling of the new products or improving the design or making betterment for the usage of any. So in the concern of safety, protecting the user from dangerous conditions and undesirable situations. So the first, the priority of the HCI goal is to making the safety for the user. So another users in the sense of users, so we have, we discuss in next lecture or either we are discussing in this if we get the space of the time. About the types of the user, we have three types of users: normal user, novel user, normal user, and expert users. So nuclear energy plant or bomb disposal operators should interact with the computer based system remotely. So this is the safety of the users according to the severity or the behavior of the environment. Medical equipment and intensive care unit also can be cared by the designers. Data also asset of any kind of organization. So prevent user from making serious errors by reducing risk of wrong. In the banking sector, in the corporate sector, some end users cannot be allowed to access the database system. So because of the safety of the data for the organization. Okay. Here we have utility, extent of providing the right kind of functionality so that users can do what they need or want to do. extendability, the utility, all the functionalities, all the requirements of the users can be fulfilled by the designer, so that it satisfy the user fully by the design, by the product. High utility scientific calculator provides many mathematical operations, including algebraic operations, built-in formulas, and its programmable. So now, effectiveness. Low utility software drawing tool does not allow freehand drawing, but only supports polygon shape drawing. So this is a low utility, high utility. These are the functionalities including in the design of the chair. Effectiveness concern users. Effectiveness concern a user's ability to accomplish the desired goal or to carry out the work. Effective, how the design is usable and effective are validated. If what is the find a master thesis in our library web, such kind of example. Any difference between utility and effectiveness? What is the difference in effectiveness? User's ability to accomplish. Effectiveness concerned with the user's ability, and whereas the utility is concerned with the functionality of the design or the product. So this is the difference. You can read this PPT when uploaded. Goals. Efficiency. Mere how quickly users can efficiency concerned this parameter of the HCI is concerned quickly users can accomplish their goals. For example, if we introduce any product or software, users without any proper or training can accomplish the task. So this is the efficiency of the product. Find a book whose title contains human computers in our library. If we are catching easily, that means the product or software is feasible and efficient for the all utilities. How about the newest book in the subject of human computer interaction? So this can be, if we are finding this question on the any software, that means that we are facilitated and if the product is efficient. Again, welcome to all who are joining after all difficulties. HCI goal explained in this picture. Okay. HCI usability, ease of learning and ease of use. What is usable? When we can learn the application or software or any kind of product or design, and ease of use without any detailed training or procedure, that means it's a good usable. Can I use the basic functions of a new digital camera without reading the manual? Does the software facilitate us to learn new functions easily? So this is the usability. Usability means a user can easily learn and get in touch with the product. So appealing, how well the user likes the system. It's a very important. If the all things are very good, but they are not appealing, means in the organization, in the any company, if product introducing the product, if it is not into appealing, but all other components or parameters are very on best level, so after all, the user is the central part of this design. If user are not encouraged or appealed for the use, it means that all the efforts are failed to satisfy the user. So appealing, although it's a last part, but it's a very important part in the HCI. in the appealing, first impression is a last impression, appeal the user, encourage, enforce the user to get in touch. And long-term satisfaction means they functionally satisfy all goals, all requirements of the user. Use Microsoft Word as an example. Goal, safety, yes, we achieved. Example, warning for exit from before save. If we are using typing any document, we alert before getting out from the document. Utility, a lot of word processing functions provided, we are satisfied. Effectiveness, as science, a student can edit equations. It means the all type of the fields can be whatever engage in the script writing, mathematical writings can be satisfied. Efficiency, yes, default template avoids initial document setting. So every utility, effectiveness and efficiency, user can driven without any training. Usability, icons help you ease of learning. Means usable is that icons and their text are helping user to go through what user wants. Appealing, interface attractive. Means the interface does not bore the user when they interact with the software. So these are the goals. Gaining benefits, what are the benefits of gaining market share if the product is good from all the parameters we discussed earlier. It means people intend to buy used products with higher usability. Google search engine has the largest market share because it is easy to use with higher efficiency without any training. Every user with even uneducated can be guided with all functionalities, efficiencies and effectiveness, and also appealing to the users. Even children also can interact with this product without any training. So it will gain the market share and progress and design improve itself. Improving productivity applies in company perform their jobs in a faster manner. Workers, man-led, company need to press highly length sequence of buttons in performing a task. So improving productivity, when we are gaining the higher share, so we are productivity also improved. And these are the benefits. Lower support costs, at lower support costs. If we are improving our gaining the share, ultimately the share, the cost will be decreased due to the increase of the users. Reducing development cost, it will reduce the development cost. Avoiding implementing features users do not want and creating features that are annoying or inefficient. If there are too many unnecessary confirmation dialog boxes in using a word processor, it is likely this product needs to be redeveloped. So, because if user are facing some difficulties and does not satisfy the user's demand, it reducing. It will hazard for the application and board the user. So that if we are getting in touch with any application such as MS Word and without any difficulties, the cost will be reduced if we are not having any queries about the application. Let's see another. This is an example you will see in the PPT after recording. This is an example of how good user experience may not guarantee final success. It means that if we have good users, but we cannot compete in the market due to some issues. In this example, its founder mentioned with plenty of investor praising it, but not a single commitment for new funding. So this is the management. Designing experts have the problem to cannot improve the design, but expecting that user satisfied from such like an example of the Nokia company. In the previous decades, Nokia captured the market share. Now Nokia all products are wiped out because they do not change the making change in the product. So that's why the company wiped out from the market, and other companies are coming into the getting share out because they satisfy the user. They read the user's senses, and they improve their designs according to their demands. So that's all about it. Good and poor design arises in our daily life. Every year we see the good designs and bad designs occur. So elevator controls and labels on the button rule in this example, about the elevator controls and labels, it look like the same. And so easy to push and label by mistake instead of control buttons. So whenever we have two same design tags, and use it will confuse the user what to do and what will be the function of that. That's why good design, user must not be confused about the usage, about the any kind of manual. Without any manual or instructions, user can understand the use of the things. So that's why this is the good and poor design differences. We have several examples about this. Cursor keys. Listen, this cursor, and then this example, we have different shape of normal shape of cursors. Here, a user misguided or in this section, we see. In this figure, we have poor design, which it will confuse the user about this cursor key. So whenever we have this arrow, the placement and the usage and the design, this is a poor design. We cannot say that this is a bad design, but this is a poor design. This will confuse our board or a little bit make a user to think about it, what will be happened and when we press it. So this is the poor design, and it shall be avoided in the okay. Is it good design? Why or not? So you will think about it. This is the another design, bind gloss, have the shipping. Is it a good design? Why or not? Yeah, or you think it has a problem. So this is a lift buttons, and it if we guide it from this without any manual, then it is good design, either good or bad. In this also we have good and poor design examples. What will assume if we will see this kind of designs, and do you know how to use them without any labeling? There's no labels available in these there's no guided manuals, and there's no any sign of understanding what is this and what is this mean. So this is also a good and poor design, and labeler and demo and both label makers. What should be the, we go to the another design, which one is the better one? This is also good poor design examples. This is guided menu. You click here and here. Eyes open and eyes closed. It's on and off. So let's see another example of good or poor design. This is the interface PowerBoard 97. Good employer. Here, guided icons will help to understand without any instructions, training. So, any suggestion on good and poor design? Are you sure of you in the messages? If we understand easily, these messages are very familiar in all applications. If user easily understand the message and the simplicity of the message or the text, then it means the application is well utilized. Okay, see. This is another design, chair or table. Here we see we can utilize chair. For example, you know that these kind of designs, although are versatile, but if a novel person come into this room, cannot understand either they are chairs or the tables. If it is in this structure, user cannot understand what is this. Is it a chair or table to use? In this, if we see in this section, we can utilize both ways for chair and both purposes. So is this good design or bad design or normal design? Another example, we see what disciplines control to HCI. Academic discipline, computer science, develop programming languages, system architectures of the computing systems, engineering, provide faster and cheaper equipments, linguistic artificial intelligence, speech synthesis, recognition, natural language processing, and art, robotics, etc., pervasive computing, and psychology, provide information about human mental capabilities, memory, ergonomics, human factors, provide information about human physical capabilities. Sociology, in the field of sociology, HCI contribute how people interact in the groups. Design practice, graphical designs, art of combining text and graphics and communicating an effective message, and design of posters, brochures, signs, logos, and other type of visual communications. Product design, industrial design, film industry, every discipline, almost around the world, HCI exists. Here the block diagram, general block diagram, artificial intelligence, computer science, psychology. It's a major generalized diagram to see here in the computer science, HCI exists, computer science and psychology. Psychology relating to the human factor, computer science is the relating to the industry and the field of the physical sciences. In the cognitive, social organization and sociology also relating to the human factors. These are the factors already, people inside business, interactive designers, what people are the professionals relating to the HCI business. People involved in the design of all the interactive aspects of product. We know the consultants, the researchers, it is always produce their studies about the behavior, the study about the machines around the world, how we use, how we improve the usability of the things. Usability engineering, people who focus on evaluating products using usability methods and principles. Different methods are developed to improve the product. Web designers, people who develop and create the visual design of websites such as layouts, animations, also the part of the HCI. Information architects, people who come up with the ideas of how to plan and structure interactive products. User experience designers, people who do all the above, but who may also carry out field studies into form the design of products. It's all about the research, how to develop the design, how to improve the design, how to improve the business of any kind of industry. User experience is an important concept in interaction design, and about how people feel about a product and their player and satisfaction when using it, looking at it, holding it, opening it, closing it. How smoothly a switch rotates, the sound of click, the touch of a button when pressing it. So user behavior and understanding or psychology. Enforce the designer to develop their products. So they are very activities in design. These are the design activities in the HCI. Here we have identify needs, establish requirements. The user set their user demands the goals. Then after that, it will be designed. It build an interactive barrier. And then evaluate our analysis, final product produce it. So the design process is repeated again and again in user-centered design. This is a user-centered design where we improve the products. If we cannot improve the products according to the demand of the user continuously, we cannot stay in the market and compete in the market. So this is the design, making the design process in the field of HCI. Okay, activities. These are the activities performed by the. So general principles of the HCI design are here. We see the and the user applies to all aspects of system. Principles support and usability include. The usability is a very important. Usability engineering is a very important in HCI. Without this understanding and study, we cannot improve the designs. So first, we in the usability include the compatibility, ease of learning, memorability, productivity, simplicity, flexibility, responsiveness, protection, invisible technology, control, YSUing, accessibility. These are the factors that are important in the usability. Before going to the design, we must understand the compatibility of the design, ease of learning, how easily can we learn that design or product, memorability, how much time user needs to memorize or learn, and predictively how user predicts, and simplicity, they can easily without any training or with help user can use, flexibility, ability to extend in future use, they can improve the design, responsiveness, can be effectively respond according to their demands, protections, protect the rights of the users, the assets of the users, the invisible technology, control, the user have the control of all things. Okay, somebody waiting for the. I'll see who are waiting. Thank you. Welcome, Umar. Also, you called me for the joining my team. Sorry, it is. All have already joined. These are the important factors. I will see. Principal support usability includes. These are the key parameters or notable things to improve the design of the any kind of product. So we'll go through the all themes, and we have the comparable user. We must know the users. How many types of the user? What product designed for what users? So design must be appropriate and compatible with the needs of the user client. Client is a good advisor for improving the design. Effective design starts with the understanding the users' needs and adopting the user's point of view. One common among designers is to assume that users are all alike. Means we are assuming. There's no assumption. There's no any confusion about the users' difference. So if we are designers assuming that all users are same and they have no difference, so we must differentiate about that. We have different users for different kind of users, a normal user, and have their natural differences. There are so many differences. Guys, so we must understand that we have now generally when we getting the information about the organization, we have three types of users: novel user, a very normal user, and an expert user. To complete these designs in that year, one common error among designers is to assume that users are alike. Another is to assume that all users think, feel, and behave exactly like the developer. It's not true. Users' behavior, attitude, and thoughts are different, and they cannot match with the designer. So designer do not think like that, and they understand, they read the senses of the user, the needs of the user, the behavior, the psychology of the user. And another thing, the product can reduce both learning time and errors. So intended user of a new system is often the user of the other systems are earlier version of them. So expectations and level of knowledge have been established and will be important. And it's both learning time. If the product are well designed according to the user design, it can reduce the learning time and errors. Means the new user, the new comer, the customer make very little errors or reduce the time of them. So it is a product's usability and we say the effectiveness. If it is effective, compatibility, if these cannot be applied to the new system, confusion results and learning requirements are greatly increased. If the compatibility system cannot be improved with other products or such like that, if we have producing the RAM with the different kind of designs for different computers, it cannot be improved. It cannot be get the right share in the market. Such like that, Mac have their own operating systems, so they have limited share. Whereas the Android have a generalized system, can be employed any of the product of the mobile system. So this is the difference between the compatibility. So it will, they have some advantages, some disadvantages. But we are focusing on the how many okay, you guys, the comparability relating to the yes, task comparable task is the organization of a system should match the task a person must do to perform the job. If we as set a task to complete from the any kind of design or application, it must be completed within due time, without any delay, without any guidance, without any training. For example, if I am going to type some kind of application on the different ways according to the existing mode, I can do without any help and without any in the application, so that we understand that the task is completed without any help. So it must be included with the application. Listen, guys, go to the another workflow. Computer applicability workflow, ease of learning, easily can be learned, and the system can be learned without delay. And memorability, we just like that, if we introducing some product and getting teaching some customers how to use that, it can be memorable. The functions, the needs, the utilities can be memorable for long time. So easily can be learned. It will influence the usability about the, if the the terms used for the functions or icons or any kind of formulas are difficult to such like in the Excel, we cannot easily memorize the formulas. So we go to the icons. But if it is not available in the icons, if we cannot guide it through the some kind of application, so Excel is a little bit harder than the MS Word to use. So memorability in the Excel, in the sense of usability, is more difficult or hard than the MS Word. This is a difference between the memorability of things, how we use the functions of the easily functions of the any product. Location, such like location, it will be easier to remember if a particular object is placed in a consistent location. And logical grouping, it will be easier to remember if things are grouped logically. Conventions, conventional objects and symbols will be easier to remember. So these are the three major memorability. Predictability factor involves a person's expectations and has his or her ability to determine the results of actions ahead of time. It includes consistency, generalizability, familiarity, and conventions. So these are the factors. First, we see the consistency. Consistency reinforces our associations and therefore increase our ability to remember and predict outcomes and processes. Same format in command screen layout and navigation. Increase our ability to remember and predict outcomes. If we are going to the giving any command, control save, it will save the document at the requested location. So this is a concern. If we are going to press any kind of button, it will jump. It will provide that facility. Generalizability, generalized. Help us use the knowledge we gather from previous experience and apply it similar situations. We learn from the some applications, such like if we have used MS Word, we can easily, without any guidance, can use the Notepad. So it is a generalized ability. If we have ability to drive the cycle, we ride a cycle, it will help to ride the motorbike easily. This is a generalized ability. Familiarity, a user's knowledge and experience. A user's knowledge and experience in other domain can be applied when interacting with a new system. Familiar, user's knowledge and experience in other domain can be easily applied when entering. If we have understanding of the Excel database system or other database, simple database, we can understand the other type of database, such like SQL database and other type of. So this is the familiarity. We have understanding of the systems and another new upcoming any applications in same field can be easily understand. So this is the familiarity. Okay. Another factor of that Conventions allow us to use our intuitions, which are based on previous experience and logic. If something is consistently done in a particular way, it will eventually become the conventional way of doing it. These conventions are the ability to use the things according to the environment. We have left-drived cars or vehicles in the foreign countries, whereas in our country we have the right-handed cars and vehicles. So the convention, according to the convention, every vehicle have the right-drived cars, and all the routes and all the systems relating to the roads are managed or designed according to the convention of the right-handed vehicles. So it means that which are based on the previous experience logic. In previous experience logic, in previous environment or in the society, what we are doing is these are the conventions. We have to focus in such design. Simplicity is a very important role, has a very important role in the design. Without simplicity, you cannot enforce or encourage the user to use the design. It will improve the productivity, the design. It will enforce the user to use it. If things are simple, they will be easily to understand, this easy to learn and remember. This is the very simple formula about the design. Google have the simple and easily can be used for every user without any training and without any guidance and manual or instructions. Simplicity, it includes a progressive disclosure, show the user only what is necessary. Means we just show what user needs only. Do not confuse or making confuse or bored or any kind of irritation of to the user about the design. So just showing that what user needs. So this is a progressive in disclosure. Constraints involve limiting the action that can be performed in a particular design. Constraints are those we are facing the problems in the design. Involve limiting the action that can be performed in a particular design. What should be limited? If we cannot complete the easily task, we cannot include everything in the application. So that's why the constraints selected, what constraints, hard and soft constraints be included in the design according to the cost, according to the user demand, understanding and level of psychology, and according to the user's behavior. So constraints are hard and soft reviewed according to the user's behavior. Flexibility. These are the flex, how much allow user control and accommodates. Here we have some skills and preferences give us user choice. Flexible means every kind of users, from age restrictions, from the gender restrictions, from the social and economical classes of the user. It means that every class of the user can use that application or any kind of product easily. So this application should be flexible for every user, for without any. And this will give the choice to the user how to use this application or product. Hardware level, on the software level, and on the data level. Okay. This is also explained in the responsiveness. The system must rapidly respond to the users according to their request or demand. Means if I need some kind of photos to be pasted in the MS Word document, then it can easily be available or utilized. If it does not respond such like that user demand, it means it have the less responsiveness. Provide immediate acknowledgement for user actions, visual, textual, and arbitrary, so that it will guide user what happened with that applications. So it must be responsive and protection. Protect users against disaster results of common human errors. So this is also another kind of invisible technology. In general, the user should need to know as a little as possible about the technical details of how the system is implemented and the updates. We know the applications, generally we don't need the full detail of the behind the application, what volume of data required to store that application, and how much the pages are can be. These are the hidden or invisible facts about the application or a product, which can be learned by the any kind of documents. So users should need to know, means we provide the full detail or information about the usage of the or limitation of the applications or product, and the facts, dangerous facts about the application, technical details about regarding the usage of that. This is the invisible facts technology. Control. Users prefer to feel a sense of mastery and control over the system. User have the authority to control the products or applications. There's no any other question about that. So we need to understand the user's preference and feelings and sense of priorities. It is frustrating and demoralizing when the user is being controlled and directed by the machine. So it is unnatural. Means we haven't any control. We are derived from by the application. It is frustrating and demoralizing, and it will irritate the user, insecure the user's priority. So users cannot satisfy with these kind of applications. Okay guys, we have some. Yes, so this is the application or product or any kind of machine does not have authority to control the user. And so if there are any kind of such kind of things, such like in sometimes and some games are controlling the user according to behavior, so this is very dangerous and frustrating. Socially and economically and so on. Okay guys. What you get in. This is the adverb which will what you see, what you get. If you seeing something, you are understanding something. So this is the easily, the things should be easily understandable about from the first look and appearance. Accessibility, degree to which a product is accessible by many people as possible. The accessibility is playing key role. If we have application, we cannot allow more than 10 users to assess at the time. Means the accessibility capability is very important in the design. So focus on disability, including visual impaired who need magnifier to see, or blind color blind who are not able to distinguish two colors, dyslexia who have difficulties in reading and writing, people with missing limbs. Now a legal issue, disability discrimination ordinance. So the accessibility means we are in some, you know that in some social networks are allowed on the age restriction about any product. So this is the accessibility, age restricted accessibility, the user's class restricted accessibility, and so on. These are the accessibility degrees about the products, about the users. These are the general principles of HCI designs. Satisfying principles do not support user's experience. Do not support user's experience. We don't need the user experience, but we are just getting the go through about satisfying the user. Fun, like application, enjoyable, entertaining, helpful, surprising, and aesthetically pleasing, rewarding, supporting of creativity, emotionally fulfilling, boring, frustrating, annoying. These are the, we say, the constraints are key parameters, general principles of design. According to the, so we must think about the user's experience. And so this is not the past. We think we get into touch with the user experience. This is satisfying. Means we in this time we have the some kind of class of users. After 1 hour, we increase the users class, and they will change the satisfying motives or any kind of priorities set by the user. So if we have the users increase in the age wise, the priorities are changed. So this will reflect or enforce the designer or the product producer about the usage of the product. So listen, satisfying, fun, enjoyable, entertaining, helpful, helpful, surprising. These are about the future of the users, future demands of the users. So we does not rely on the previous experience of the users. So what previous experience of the users are also important, but the, if we are going to generalize the principle, then we have these factors about the user to satisfy. We are assuming or predicting that in 10, in upcoming 10 years, a whole world will be changed and will be diverted to the robotics and pervasive computing. So this is our expectation. So we are going to plan the expectations about the users. So we have no previous experience about the user experience regarding these factors. That will not helpful for the any kind of product improving. Okay, guys. Somebody waiting for that. Welcome to all of you again. So this generalized principles. So to understand these factors, we have to Norman's principle of usability. Norman is a cognitive psychologist, expertise in the computing science cognition, refer to how we gain the knowledge, includes understanding, remembering, reasoning, acquiring skills, creating new ideas. So this is the principle, a popular psychologist expert about relating to computing science. Basic idea of Norman's principles are: we can learn from common objects to improve the design. We are able to operate common objects without a user manual. Without the user manual, we are able to operate common objects without a user manual, without tags, without labels. The objects should provide some cues. If a simple piece of equipment such as door or kitchen stove requires labeling, the need is sign of design failure. Visibility, affordance, mapping, constraints, feedback. A product or design with good usability should provide perceptual cues for us to answer these questions. Can we see the interface elements related to visibility? If our design are visible, then all elements should be on display mode, can be easily visible. What do you perceive you can do with the interface related to affordance? What is affordance means? If we have the lock, it must be locked by the key and unlocked by the key. So this is the affordance about the lock. How our interaction is constrained by the interface related to the constraint. What is supposed to happen when we interact with the interface related to mapping and feedback? This is the Norman's principle of usability. Visibility interface feature is accessible to a human sense organ. Interface, for example, we are using the any kind of search engine, it can be easily visible, can be usable for all kind of users, all class of users, all level of users. So this is the visibility. Then such like incoming voicemails, the number of mails, etc. Indicate what parts operate and how. Indicate how user is to interact with the device. So this is the visibility. The more visible functions are, the more likely users will be able to know what to do next. If there are more visible functions, the user can easily understand the design without any help. If we have in the normal telephone design, we have limited buttons to operate, whereas in the latest design, we have multiple buttons and many functionalities or utilities. Without manual, we cannot understand the usage of this kind of form. So this is the user visibility. We cannot understand what happened with these buttons. We have multiple usage of these buttons. So in upper and lower case, so without the tag or manual, we cannot use this. So this is the difference between the Norman's principles of the usability. Which one is higher visibility? It has higher visibility because every button are numerical and phone number. Here, every button also including the alphabets and cannot be understood what alphabet cared with the what usage. So this is the difference between the higher visibility and lower visibility. Yes, okay. Another example of Norman's principle of visibility. Here we have three examples of bottles. Here we have which one salt is shaker, which is pepper shaker, which pair is of higher visibility. So this pair had higher visibility to display the good design, to understand the user, to make the understanding of the user easily. This is salt, this is the pepper shaker. So in this picture, we cannot understand what is inside that. In this design is good, but it is not visible for the user, cannot be understood by the user. SP, salt, pepper. It is labeled also, it is not labeled. This is the design without guidance or instruction, it cannot be utilized. and this can be easily visible for every user. This is not visible for every user inside what happened in the bottle. Norman's principle also have another example. Listen, this is a control panel of an elevator. How does it work? Push a button for the floor you want. Nothing happens. Push any other button. Still nothing. So this is the usability of things. You see another example. Need to insert your room card in the slot first. How would you make this action more visible? So make the card reader more obvious. Provide an arbitrary message that says what to do. Provide a big label next to the card reader that flashes when someone enters. So this is the usability and visibility. Hey guys, this is another kind of usage of things, visibility. You see in this previous and previous, here we have same labels. So although this is also guided to the previous, we have previous and next. This is the difference in the design. What should be the next? Previous and next. Okay, so this is the visibility. Norman's principle of usability in the applications, guided by the icons. These icons will guide the user what to do. This is a specification labeling, and it can easily understand by the user. So if the software checking plagiarism, then it will show the detail of the plagiarism inside this plagiarism checking software portal, in which it will display all the visible things about the plagiarism. How many plagiarism is available in the document. Hey guys, any improvements? If we improve the document plagiarism, it can be showed on the the software. It means it will display all the utility visible things about the plagiarism in the software. So it has the good design in the sense of usability. The user received any feedback, comments, constraints, restricting the possible action that can be performed at given moment. Some menu options will be deactivated by shading them at some occasions. Avoid wrong use of thing. Help prevent users from the selecting incorrect options. So these are the also three major usability constraints: physical, logical, and cultural. These are the three major constraint levels: physical, logical, and we have discussed in the previous classes. These concepts are very important relating to the any design concept, either it is conceptual modeling or the mental modeling. Common specific physical constraints. What are the physical constraints? Physical objects can be designed to constrain things, and this constraint restrict the user interaction. How many ways can you insert electrical plug to a socket? How about inserting a CD into a computer? Which of them has a better physical constraint? So this is the design, which has the best design in the usage. This is a physical constraint. Physically, it has some rules, some specifications, some way out, or connectivity. So more possible interpretation are, I think, is user can understand without any help to use these things physically. Logical concept exploit people's common sense reasoning about actions and their sequence. When no object is selected, it is not allowed to use the cut command and word. So this is the logical constraint. If we cannot select any document, we cannot cut the use the cut command in the any kind of word, any kind of applications. So this is the logical constraint in any design. Cultural constraint. Society has evolved numerous artificial conventions that govern acceptable social behavior. These cultural conventions have to be learned, but once learned, they apply to a wide variety of circumstances. Red color stands for danger, while green color stands for safe. Smiling face stands for happy emotions. So these are the cultural constraints about the usability of things and according to the environment, according to the social behavior, according to religious behavior, according to the geographical behavior. So this varies according to their environment in the cultural constraints. Such like the red color is danger, sign of danger, whereas the smile means emotion, smile emoji stand for the happiness. Light switch. In light switch, we have the physical constraints. In America, down is off. In Britain, down is on. So this is a cultural, physical cultural difference between the two geographical locations, two societies. Water tap in America, anti-clockwise is on. Britain, anti-clockwise is off. Red color. In America, assumed as danger. In Egypt, death. In India, life. And in China is the sign of happiness. So this is a cultural constraint difference. Affordance refer to an attribute of an object that allows people to know how to use it. It is affordance. Give clues to the operations of things. Indicate what thing is, how to use the things. Cup of tea and the handle of the door. Okay, guys, indicate how thing could possibly be used. So this is affordance, means handle of the door used for opening the door. This is affordance. A cup of tea, holding the tea inside the cup. So this is the affordance. I mean, it's affordable to get to fill the teas in the cup. So we see in the another example, milk, butter, cheese, water, beer, wine. These are the examples. Milk, butter, cheese. Milk, butter, cheese are have the relationship, and water, beer, wine, what is the difference between them? Well, scroll bar afford moving up and down, is icons afford clicking on them. If we are scrolling, moving our mouse button have the ability to move to select from the menu. It is affordable to select from the scroll from the top to the bottom for the options. So it is affordance. Okay, guys. Norman's principle of usability. This is also another example of affordance. There are two kinds of affordance: real and perceived. For physical objects, and do not have to be learned. Means physically without any help we can use the things. That's a real affordance. And perceived option for skill based enterprises can be considered as a learned convention. Means we are assuming, and we are assuming that it will be happened when we hit the key or push the button. So this is a perceiving. Means we are assuming some kind of actions to be happened. Whether they are happening or not. Mapping is a natural relation between controls and their effects. Move mouse to left to right. goes left to right. These are mapping available and feasible for the design. Upper button controls upper bulbs while lower controls lower bulbs. It's a natural mapping. So Naumann's principles, another example, timer knob in a microwave oven is of a good mapping because turning it clockwise implies increasing clock time. The knob affords you to turn it as a, it is a, another example. Slider bar, another example, it is affordable, movable for by the cursor. Another example of this A, B, C, D we have. Which controls go with which burner? It is confusing. It is not guided. A mapping is not well mapped. So user confused here. Try to all the things for the using when use it. So that is also in the not a good design. Is it better? We have in sequence, so it is much better than our previous. Which arrow key layout is the best one? We see which one is the best one. This one, or this one, or this one. All have the different designs, but what should be the good design according to user's usage? So this is another design, pull and push concepts about the cupboard. This is an algo push and close. Any suggested improvements in this design? Another design of the which Naumann's principle have been applied in this education toy. So you can try the, is it employed, visible, and also the affordable or not. So then another, which Naumann's principle have been applied in this unit? Visibility, affordance, and mapping. Another example of this, how about this? What is the meaning of three black dots in yellow? These are buttons, or the other things are any kind of movement of that? So this design will misguide. Here we see different vibrating patterns to indicate states of pedestrian signal. So directional arrow to indicate the direction of the pedestrian cross. This is the provided for visual impairment persons to use. Have you misused it? Yes. Conceptual modeling. What is the conceptual modeling and mental modeling? I have already recorded about that in the video, which will be uploaded on the YouTube channel and shared with you people today, sooner or later, inshallah. In the conceptual modeling is a fundamental aspect of the HCFR interaction designers. This is a high level description of how a system product is organized and operates. That's it. This is the classic example, is a star interface by zeros. So conceptual modeling on the paper, we are suggesting or designing some kind of applications through the model. Target for the purpose based on the analogy to physical office, metaphors, papers, folders, filing cabinets, etc. Using the system concept, dragging and electronic. So conceptual model. Another example, recycle bin in Windows 7. What is your understanding on the recycle bin? A place for deleting objects, drag objects to be deleted to the bin. Suppose a company wants to, suppose company wants to develop a mobile app for facilitating tourists to hike in Hong Kong. How to develop a conceptual model for this system? What questions should be asked in developing the conceptual model? Suggestion: who are they? Speaking Chinese or foreigners who speak English? What do they want? Hiking information: how to get a particular hike in Hong Kong? For a particular hike, what is the difficulty level? How about the hiking time? How to support the activity of requesting information in the optimum way? A menu system or voice command activity system? Provide a system that structures information in the form of list, maps, recommendations. So this is another example to be considered for the understanding of the conceptual modeling. Okay, thank you very much, guys. This is today's lecture, and inshallah we meet again on the next week. And these also recorded and prepared video lectures about the HCI will be uploaded on the YouTube channel. And thank you very much for joining us. I am going to stop the sharing this video, and hopefully you enjoyed this session. And in the next session, you will give me the feedback. Before the comments of the next session, you will give me feedback. Hopefully all you will be prepared and joined in the next week. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz. Take care of all of you. And Allah Hafiz. Thank you very much.